Hello student, myself Nazneen Akhtar. Welcome to my study channel Naz Studies. The topic of today is about fungi, and today we will go on the general characteristic of fungi. The topic of fungi we will go in an elaborate form in the next and further video, but the first class we will discuss about the fungi is about its general characteristic. So what is fungi? Fungi are the group of diverse and fascinating organisms that belong to their own kingdom, distinct from plant, animal and bacteria. We can also say like that it's a special group of plant that lack chlorophyll and include thalloid eukaryotic heterotrophic organism, and they are exist in a variable form in the variable behavior and life cycle. So what come under fungi? Like yeast, mold, mildews, mushroom, rust and smut. So there are different types of fungi we will study when we look the diversity of the fungi. So the word fungus is originated, it is originated from the Latin word that is means fungus, and fungus meaning mushroom. So the fungi is what? It's a diverse and fascinating organism. And second, we can say it is eukaryotic organism. Eukaryotic means it has the cell that have well defined nucleus and membrane bound organelles. Means the nucleus is there and also the organelles are membrane bound. Fungi can be either multicellular like mushroom and mold, and unicellular like yeast. Mainly the fungi are in the multicellular form, but exceptional cases is like in yeast. Unlike plant, we know plant perform photosynthesis and plant have chlorophyll, but the and so it is autotrophic organism, but fungi are heterotrophic organism, means it depend upon other organism for its food. It cannot produce their own food. So if they cannot produce their own food, then how they take their nutrition? They take their nutrition or by means of absorption, means they absorb nutrient from their environment, and how they can do it? By secreting enzyme. And what's by secreting enzyme, it help in breaking down the complex organic matter into simpler form, and then they take their the digested nutrient from it or absorb the digested nutrient. Another characteristic is about the cell wall. Mainly the cell wall is found in plant and that is made of cellulose. But in case of fungi, we see the cell wall is made of a complex sugar and that is called as chitin. And chitin provides the structure support to the fungal cell. Fungi reproduce by producing spores, microscopic reproductive cells that can survive harsh conditions. Mainly production of fungi is by spores, and the spores are haploid microscopic reproductive cell, and it can live in the harsh condition also and capable of spreading over long distance, aiding in dispersal and survival of fungi. Fungi play a crucial role in various ecosystems, act as decomposer, and under the five kingdom classification as proposed by R.A. Shutekar, he called fungi as a multicellular decomposer because it breaks down the organic matter, recycle nutrient and play a vital role in the carbon cycle. Thus, in this way, fungus play important role in ecosystem. Some fungi act as a beneficial relationship with plant, such as mycorrhizal association, where the plant where help plant absorb water and nutrient from the soil. Other can be parasitic, means it can cause disease in plant, animal and human. Fungi exhibit a wide range of lifestyle. Some are saprophyte, feeding on dead and decaying matter. Other are predator, capturing and digesting small organisms, while some form a mutualistic relationship with other organisms such as lichen. So there we will see various mode of life of fungi. Some are saprophyte, some are predator, and some are symbiosis, that is showing mutualistic relationship. And in case of lichen, we see the mutual relationship and the association of fungi with the algae. फंजे कैन बी रिप्रोड्यूस बोथ सेक्सुअली एंड एसेक्सुअली। सेक्सुअली मीन्स द टू माइसिलियम हैविंग टू डिफरेंट मेटिंग टाइप, दे फ्यूज, दे कम टुगेदर, क्लोज टुगेदर एंड फ्यूज, रिजल्टिंग द सेक्सुअली प्रोसेक्सुअल प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन। एंड सम रिप्रोड्यूस एसेक्सुअल। एसेक्सुअल मेड ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन इज थ्रू द स्पोर्स प्रोडक्शन और फ्रेगमेंटेशन ऑफ हाइपे। The body of a typical fungus is composed of thread-like structure. Very important how the body of the fungus look like. So the body of the fungus is called as hyphae, that is a thread mass of thread-like structure. And this mass of thread-like structure in a network form mycelium. So from the hyphae mycelium is originate. And mycelium, what is mycelium? It is the main feeding and vegetative structure of fungus. Fungus have significant economic importance and various application in industry and medicine. So this is the economic importance of fungi. They are used in production of food, baking, brewing, cheese making, antibiotic, that is in the pharmaceutical company. So many antibiotics are produced from the fungus. One example here is given is penicillin. And various enzymes are also produced in biotechnology. Overall, fungi are a diverse and essential group of organisms with unique characteristics and ecological role that contribute to the balance and functioning of ecosystem. So, what are the main characteristics we will look here? Characteristic. Just a summarized form in a point. First we call it as a multicellular living the yeast, which is unicellular. Fungus are multicellular. Second, fungus are eukaryotic. Third is decomposer. Fourth is heterotrophic. Fungus wall, that is cell wall, is made of chitin. Cell is a network of hyphae, that is mycelium, that is cell structure of body structure of fungus is made of mycelium. Reproduction is my means of spores, which is asexual mode, and sexual mode is by two mycelium. Reproduction is my means of spores, which is asexual mode. And sexual mode is by two mycelium, of different, that is one act as a male and one act as a female, different mating type. Okay. Another is your about mode of life. Mode of life means we can say in which is conditions in or where fungus is occurring, and according to its occurrence it is of different type. Fungus are mainly saprophyte, and we know about the saprophyte depend on dead and decay for its nutrition. Some act as a parasite, and parasite can be ecto and endo. Ectoparasite. Another one is एंडोपैरासाइट, ठीक है, एंड एक्टो मीन्स दोज ग्रो इन द सर्फेस ऑफ द होस्ट, एंड एंडो मीन्स दोज ऑकर इन साइड द होस्ट बॉडी और सेल ऑफ टिश्यू एंड दे आर नॉट विजिबल. एंड वी विल ऑल्सो से दैट द पैरासाइटिक फंगे कैन बी ऑब्लिगेट पैरासाइट. दिस पैरासाइट कैन बी ऑब्लिगेट पैरासाइट. फैकल्टेटिव पैरासाइट, फैकल्टेटिव पैरासाइट एंड फैकल्टेटिव सेप्रोफाइट, फैकल्टेटिव सेप्रोफाइट एंड वन मोर इज अबाउट द सिम्बायोसिस. And symbiosis in fungus is one we can see in case of lichen. Another is your mycorrhizal association in plant, where the fungus make a association with the root of the plant and help in the absorption of nutrient from of the and give to the supply to the plant. It also in this way it acts as a symbiosis. And in case of obligate parasite are the parasite that grow that can grow upon the suitable host and cannot complete their life cycle without the host. And facultative parasite is the parasite when the fungus grow normally as saprophyte but can be parasite when host is available. And facultative saprophyte is the when the fungus normally grow as a parasite but can be live on dead and decompose organic matter as a saprophyte at times when the host is not available. So these are the three different types of parasite: obligate, facultative and facultative parasite and facultative saprophyte. So this is all over the today class about the general characteristics which we go now about the characteristic of this fungus, multicellular eukaryotic decomposer. Multicellular eukaryotic decomposer, heterotrophic, cell wall is made of chitin, cell structure is made of a network of hyphae that is called as mycelium, reproduction is mainly by spores that is asexual mode, sexual mode is by two mycelium of two different mating type, mode of life is saprophyte, parasitic is ecto and endotype, and the parasite types are obligate, facultative parasite and facultative saprophyte, and the third is your symbiosis. So this is overall the class on the general characteristic of fungi we have gone in detail. So this is all about today class. Wait for the next video. Like, share and subscribe my channel. Thanks.